First, we'll create the knowledge base that we'll use throughout the course, import initialization objects, and review them. Then we'll generate our system and deploy it in the cloud. Finally, we'll execute the web backend for the first time. Let's create a knowledge base using the trial version of GeneXus 16. And we'll call it Event Day. And we'll press the Create button. Let's wait a moment until the KB is generated. If you're using the full version of GeneXus, you'll see exactly the same thing, except for a few small details that we'll highlight when appropriate. Note that below root module is the GeneXus folder containing the subfolders common and web, each with some predefined objects, such as master pages, for example. In addition, there's a references node which contains submodules with read-only GeneXus objects that are already generated. So, for application builds, they will not have to be respecified and generated. About these objects, we will see only the necessary information for the developer to use them. They're mostly external objects, some of them specific for smart devices. These external objects, which, as we'll see later, will be fundamental to develop our native mobile applications. If we edit the domains, we see all the predefined domains that are created automatically. Among them, we have semantic domains, such as address, email, geolocation, phone, time, URL, and among others, whose semantics we'll see later in action. Well, now that we've gone over these issues, let's import an Xpz file where we will have already developed a series of objects on which we will build our application. This file can be downloaded from the training website in the Materials section. We select the file and click on Import. As we can see, we already have the transactions in our knowledge base. Each of the transactions has the work with for web pattern applied, and this will be part of the application web backend. We won't go into further details. If you want to learn more about this topic, you can look for more information in the GeneXus wiki. We also see that we have these objects associated with some transactions. It's a data provider that is generated when we indicate that the transaction will be used as a data provider to populate data. These objects will be executed automatically and will generate the necessary data for our application. For example, here we have the data provider associated with the country transaction. In it, we indicate that the countries Uruguay, Mexico, United States, and so on. Each should be loaded with their flag. All this is for you to start with the initialized database. If you would like to see more information on these types of data providers, you can do so in the GeneXus wiki. In this KB, we're going to use the deploy to cloud functionality. Because it's a trial version, this is the only option available. This means that our database server and our web server will be in the cloud. By default, GeneXus provides us with a site and automatically generates everything necessary in a completely transparent way for the user. Remember that we must always have an internet connection to run the application. In case you're not using the trial version, you can choose to generate your KB locally, or you can also use the cloud if you wish. We will run the developer menu for the first time. To do so, we click on this icon or press F5. The first thing we'll see is the database impact analysis, which is run by pressing on Create. If you haven't associated a user account with the GeneXus trial, it's possible that GeneXus prompts you to enter a username and password from the GeneXus website. If you don't have one, you can create it directly. This username will be then associated with the application deployed in the GeneXus cloud. We can see that all the programs of the web backend of our application are being generated. We can see that here the transfer of all the compiled programs to the cloud has already started, which will then be automatically deployed. Now the initialization data providers we had defined will run automatically. By default, the page called Developer Menu will be opened. From there, we have links to various objects in the KV and access to each one of them. We enter the home, which has links to the work with objects that we've already applied. We enter companies and see that the information is already loaded in the database. Now we access countries, and we can see that everything here is also ready. These pages will allow making insertions or updates to the database. This will be our entire web backend. In the next video, we'll begin to talk about the characteristics of the SD application that we will create.